Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to use laws of logarithms to simplify a logarithmic function. To complete this problem, we'll first identify the laws we need to use and then apply them to our logarithmic function in order to simplify it. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to use laws of logarithms to evaluate log base 2 of 80 minus log base 2 of 5. And we're going to be using two laws of logarithms here. One is log base a of x minus log base a of y can be converted into log base a of x divided by y. And the other one is log base a of x equal to y can be converted into a to the y equals x. So let's just take this one step at a time and go through this problem. We're trying to simplify this original problem as much as we can. So we're going to first equate our original problem to the first definition we have here. We can see that when we have two logs with the same base, log base a and log base a, of x and y, and we have the same bases here, we have 2 and 2 with different x and y, where our x is equal to 80 and our y is equal to 5. We can convert that into log with the same base, so we'll still have base 2. We put x in our numerator and y in our denominator. The important thing to note about this definition is this negative sign here. So if we had, for example, negative log base a of x plus log base a of y, the important piece to realize is that whichever one of these is the negative log goes in the denominator over here, and whichever one is the positive goes in the numerator. So in our case, log base 2 of 80 is positive. This log base 2 of 5 is negative. So we're going to put 80 in the numerator and 5 in the denominator. So our log base 2 of 80, so log base 2 of 80 minus log base 2 of 5 will become log base 2 of 80 over 5. Obviously, we can simplify that by dividing 80 by 5, and we'll get log base 2 of 16, because 80 divided by 5 is 16. So now we've got something that's much simpler than what we started with, but we can still simplify further. So if we use our second rule here, that log base a of x is equal to y, something in that form can get converted to a to the y equals x. All we have to do here is take our log base 2 of 16, and let's go ahead and set that equal to, let's call it y, to keep it in the same format or as close to the same format as our definition here. So if we set that equal to some variable, in this case we'll just call it y, then we can transform our log base 2 of 16 equals y into this second form here, a to the y equals x. So notice that the log base a will go away completely. So notice that the log goes away. It's nowhere to be found on the right-hand side over here, a to the y equals x. But we do have this base a, and that shows up over here on the right-hand side. So our base is 2, so we'll go ahead and write that 2. Now we're looking for the y over here. And the y in this case is what's over here on the right-hand side of our first equation. In that case, for us, we've got y. So we'll just call this 2 to the y. Now over here on the right side, all we need is x, which we know is what we've got over here with our log, and in our case, that's 16. So we'll call this 2 to the y equals 16, and that's the way that we can simplify log base 2 of 16 equal to some variable. It turns into 2 to the variable is equal to 16. And now, of course, at this point, we know that y is just equal to 4, because we know that 2 to the 4 is equal to 16. Which means that our final answer here is just 4. We can simplify our original problem, log base 2 of 80 minus log base 2 of 5, all the way down to just 4. And that's it. That's one example of how to use the laws of logarithms to simplify a problem like this one. So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.